What's going on, everybody? How you guys doing? I think this is the very first time that I've gotten the audio to work instantly on a live stream. I'm like super excited. Woo! Look at all these people joining in. I don't even know how many people we got watching right now. Woo! We got 23 people according to my count. What's going on, everybody? How y'all doing? Oh my goodness. Woo! It has been a crazy 2 weeks. Oh my goodness. 157 people watching. Wow! Dave, that's awesome. Oh, hey, Outdoor Mama's here. She's going to be helping me with all the stuff. There's a bunch of stuff down in here that you guys can't see that we're going to be going over. Because I've been gone for 2 weeks, haven't really making a lot of videos. What's going on, Hammer Time? Thanks for the super chat, brother. Means a lot, man. So I've got the giveaway winners already picked out. But I do want to go over, since you guys obviously want to know if you won or not, I have some announcements I want to give because there's a lot of cool stuff that happens. And on my big outdoor adventures, when I'm gone for 5, 7, 10, 14 days at a time, I have to spend like twice that long editing after I get back. So it's like there's these big spans of time and all this cool gear comes out. If you follow me on Instagram or on Facebook, you'll get to see those little promo videos and those fun little clips of I do like testing footage. I grab all the action footage that I would normally put in like a review video. And I kind of just display something if it ends up being really cool. And there is one thing that ended up really cool. We're going to share that with you guys here in a moment. I'm super excited. But there's a lot of cool stuff coming from a bunch of cool companies that they're not, obviously, they don't pay me. I live in a freaking 700 square foot apartment, guys. Like, I'm not, like, super rich. But hope you guys will bear with me. Like I said, I got the giveaway winners picked out over here. I'm teasing you with it, I know. But I promise it's going to make this thing worthwhile. To all of my awesome tribe members out there who are premium members, you guys are freaking amazing. You guys have been super supportive. All the moderators out there who are keeping the live streams and all the chats really clean and family friendly for us so we're not having a bunch of like super crazy trolls. Like, I want you guys to be able to kind of express your opinions and just be yourself, but we also just don't want, you know, the jerks that are throwing popcorn in the movie theater kind of thing. But anyway, one thing that I want to go over is we just got back from a trip. Whew! I was gone for 2 weeks for basically a three-day adventure. we ended up filming a bunch more videos there while we were there. We filmed stuff. We were with Four Directions Bushcraft, Chris Deslow over there. And he's an amazing outdoorsman. He's awesome with primitive skills, and he is like super knowledgeable. But his ability to, you know, tell the story visually through film wasn't as high as it could be to give you guys just ferociously good content. But he's a super adaptable, super, super smart guy. So I took all of the mistakes that I made and all the things that I learned and basically gave him like a two-week crash course to try to get him as close to catching up to where I'm basically at right now. I'm not an expert, but I am farther along in my journey for visual storytelling to kind of give you guys a fun presentation when we make videos. And I'm not gonna lie, man, Chris took all that information, bought the equipment in like a day. I was like freaking out. I thought it was gonna take him like 4 or 5 months to catch up, and he just ran with it. And one of the things he did is a new product that he's got. It's called 550 Blaze Cord. It's going to be on Four Directions Bushcraft's website. Even if you use any of the random 40B links that I've got in the video description, you'll be able to get to it. But I want to talk about that for a minute because I don't know when I'm going to be able to do the actual episode for you guys, because that episode's going to be super over the top for cordage. It's going to be pretty intense. But I kind of wanted to go over that real quick. So I'm going to show you some comparisons of kind of where the premise of my video is going to go. So if anybody copies me, reference this live stream and let them know they got it from me first. They stole my idea. I don't care. It's whatever. So, all right, here we go. So, we all know that in the beginning of time, back in the Stone Age of the internets, 550 fire cord was basically the original to market a fire or waterproof core, but they were really expensive. Super expensive. For 100 feet of this, it's like $45. I don't recommend anyone buy this. If you buy this, you're an idiot. And it's not, and if you want to support live fire, you can do that. It's not that, it's just, it's so expensive. It's a fire core inside of, it shouldn't be that expensive. So then the, you know, UST being in their fine glory, they came out with this stuff. So for $5, you got a 30-foot hank, which is pretty useless. It's not useless, but And then for, I think it's like $18 for 100 feet. So all in all, this is pretty good. And it was kind of my standard. It ended up being one of my favorite fire core waterproof cordage tenders that you can buy from a store of all time because of its price point. And its performance was pretty good. But it had a few things that it didn't like that I referenced in my other video. But then came this stuff. This is brand new. The packaging doesn't even exist yet for Four Directions Bushcraft. This is called 550 Blaze Cord. Now, what I love about this stuff is you get the fire tinder core, but you also get monofilament fishing line in there. He's selling this. 100 feet of this. Congratulations, Chris, on 200K. Good luck, everyone. Thanks, man. So, he's selling 100 feet of this for $9.99. Half the price of UST Paratender. So I was super skeptical when he told me about it. And I was like, bro, like, I'm all for you, man. You have awesome fire steels. You do some really good fatwood stuff. Like, you're usually on the ball, bro. But I have to put this through the ringer. I have to test this stuff. And just because you're my buddy, I can't give you a free pass. Because if I recommend this stuff to my subscribers, to my viewers, and they buy this 550 blaze cord and it completely sucks, I got nothing. But keep in mind, this is basically the price of normal 550 cordage. You get what I'm saying? It's $9.99 for 100 feet. You get monofilament line in there, but you get the blaze cord. And I want you guys to watch the blaze cord video. I have a video in the live stream that I'm going to stream over this. I'm going to shut up for like 40 seconds. I put this through a 5-minute water test where I dunked the core in water for 5 minutes to see if it's still light afterwards. And this was, if you follow me on Instagram and Facebook, you already saw this, but go ahead and let you guys see this, but yeah. I dunked this core. I just snipped off a piece and put it in the water for 5 minutes. And that was a super condensed 30-second clip, so it would be fast enough for social media. But this stuff worked. And did it get completely soaked and submerged in water? Yes, it did. It did get soaked. Completely soaked. Because when you snip the end of that cordage, the water can seep in where there is no longer that coverage of wax coating it anymore. So the water gets in. But what makes this work so well is the fact that you can separate all of those little things and fluff it into like a little hairball, like just like jute. And even when it gets wet, it still works flawlessly because those little microfibers is what can dries out and ignites so fast and then let you keep going. So would I recommend you use super wet cordage tinder, whether it was live fire, paratinder, or this? No, not at all. There are more powerful, more robust things out there in the worst conditions you could ever run into. But with that said, knowing that you have cordage that also has fire tinder in good or bad conditions that you know it'll work, that's awesome. Like I said, for $10 for 100 feet, it's amazing. I know he's still working on the box, and I like this so much, you can't buy it from him yet. But I gave him like $50. I gave him $50, and he gave me a 1,000-foot roll. So I have plenty of this, and I would not have bought this if I didn't believe in it. I want you guys to understand, if you like it, just go to Four Directions Bushcraft's website, blaze cord, dude, $10, 100 feet, it's freaking amazing. So, now, for anybody who, obviously, for most of y'all, 300 people who are watching, which, in fact, 300 of y'all are here, y'all are amazing, I love you guys. So, I don't have fat wood in Texas. Where I am in Texas for, like, what, 3 or 4 hours in any direction driving at 80 miles an hour, there's no fat wood, no pine, no nothing. Now, a lot of my subscribers, a lot of my viewers, you guys have been awesome. You guys reach out to me on social media, Facebook, emails, and ask for my address or P.O. box, and you guys sent me a bunch of fatwood. I got like 1,000 pounds of birch bark chaga fatwood. It was amazing. It was awesome. I am like so in love with you guys. You guys are amazing. Like in Jesus, not like, you know, what's up. So, so with that said, I got to actually harvest fatwood. I got to go to the Eastern Woodlands in a big, huge forest. And if you don't know where fatwood comes from, it comes from basically dead trees. These comes from the branches of basically, we just found rotten trees and we're looking for the telltale signs of fatwood existing, and you basically chop it up and it gets really super hard. So I wanted to show you guys my first special adventure. You guys understand it's the first time in my life I've ever collected fatwood. For y'all who live in pinewood forests, it's pretty common, so you might giggle at it, but I was very, very, very excited because I got to do it myself. So here's that little clip that I took for you guys. So I got to get my own fatwood, and with that, there is a new product from Four Directions Bushcraft going to be coming out. It's not going to be coming out like super soon because I kind of pressured him into it. He wasn't sure if he wanted to do it. But so as of right now, this is the only one that exists just like it. But this is that piece of fatwood that I actually chopped off myself, and 4DB used his awesome carving techniques and made it into like a really fun handle. But this is going to be called the Warthog. This is, he's got the 1-inch fire steels. The really big ones are called Bunker Busters. Then he has the 1/2-inch by 8-inch ones, which are called the Elites. This one's going to be called the Warthog. This is a 3/4-inch diameter. And I think this is going to be the perfect kind of like apocalyptic fire steel for pretty much everybody. It's 6 inches long, 3/4-inch thick, but you get that just insane life with it, but you don't get that super crazy weight of the 1-inch one. This is like 3 or 4, it's like 30% of the weight, so you could have just one hell of a fire steel that's just ridiculous. I mean, this thing is stupid. This thing is so big. I mean, it's bigger than the width of my finger. It's huge. And then, because I'm a super, super big nerd, I am a nerd. If you follow me on social media, I watch all the MCU movies. I watch Harry Potter. I love Star Wars. I'm a nerd. I get my knees dirty. I get my fingernails dirty, and I play out in the woods, but I'm a big nerd. I mean, I got freaking electric scooters behind me. I love Harry Potter. And why my buddy Chris was working on the Osage Orange handles, which you guys will probably see him doing some behind-the-scenes shop photos that I took for him while he was working, because he can't obviously take his own photos while he's working because he's busy, he's doing stuff. But I basically made my own version of like a Harry Potter wand out of a fire steel. I took the 8-inch fire steel Elite and the Osage Orange handle. And yes, as soon as I made this, as nerdy as it sounds, I was like, Expecto Patronum, totally did the Patronus charm in the wind, and Chris called me an idiot, but... But yeah, so this is these are one of a kind pieces. I'll probably remake something similar to them and with waxwood from Pro Camp Tech, or formerly known as Production Hangar 51, in the future. But because these are kind of like custom one-offs and they were the first ones of their kind, I'm probably not going to use them, but I'll probably throw them in photos. But you guys know me, I love starting fires, so you guys are going to see a bunch of cool fires anyway coming soon. So we got that out of the way, which is really awesome. And oh yeah, so I did, oh, right in front of me. Dude, I'm so scatterbrained because I just got home and I'm trying to catch up on everything. So, I work with a company. I like their stuff. I did, if you guys remember my favorite fire steels video that we did, it was, what was it? The Fire Tinder Go Tubes. Holy crap, how did I forget those? It's right here. I'll get them. Okay. So, these are the Fire Tinder Go Tubes. I came up with an idea to kind of like where you can stick them out. The whole concept of these is you just take them, you pour them out, strike them with a fire steel, and you're good, but it keeps everything super protected, and it's kind of a convenient way to have, like if you go on like a weekend trip or something. They're just fun, and if you needed them in a bug out bag, I mean, this little tube right here, I mean, this will last you a week if you're not a dingling about it, or you're not like in a monsoon. Should be pretty good. So, this one in particular is made of fiber light, which is a natural kind of tinder. It's basically wood fibers and wood grain, and then it's wax and some other stuff, I think. But I love this stuff. This stuff burns pretty good. It burns for like 3 or 4 minutes on its own naturally. Well, the guys over at Fiber Light decided to contact me, like, Chris, we got a really amazing idea. And I was like, okay, cool. Shoot, what is it? He goes, it's called Tinder Boost. And I'm like, okay, what's Tinder Boost? I thought I was like, is this to make sure that I get more girls to swipe left on me when I'm on Tinder? I'm kidding. Dating apps are stupid. So, no. It's called Fiber Light Tinder Boost. And it's designed to dramatically increase the burn time of any Tinder you use. So whether it's store-bought, natural, even let's say you have the stuff with you, but you don't have any Tinder at all. You don't have access to Birch. You don't have access to Fatwood. You know, whatever, for whatever reason, you're in a weird, funky spot and you need this. This stuff is designed to literally dramatically increase. And I was very skeptical. It was one of those things I was like, I don't know. I just, fat wood burns a long time. Wax wood burns a long time. Fat rope sticks burn a long time. You know, I have, all this stuff does a really good job. Holy crap. Holy crap. I thought it was fire paste at first, or like, that Coughlin's fire paste. I thought that's what this was, and I opened them both up, and I have a tube of fire paste. They are not the same. They are completely different texture, completely different consistency, completely color. It's different. It's 100% different. So I took this out. I decided to use it. And Fiberlite, like I said, burns for like 3-4 minutes. And then we went through, and I added this for the test. So I'm going through, and it's like 3 or 4 minutes have gone by. It's still on fire. And then I see my son coming home from school. And I'm like, Ryan, give me your phone. I want to time this thing. It lasted for over 7 minutes after I had been burning it for like 3 or 4 minutes and decided to finally start timing it afterwards at the very end of the video. It lasted for over 7 minutes, and it was still going. I had to just stomp it out because it was going for so long. It was literally like 12 to 17 minutes just by adding this little tiny little pouch to it. But I want you guys to see that because it's super brand new. I don't even know if it's going to be on Fiberlite's website yet, but it's really freaking rad. So I'll let you guys check a look at that real quick. Was so awesome, and it's like super conveniently pouched, and they already decided to do this. I didn't build this myself. I guess a Fiberlite's gonna be selling these, but these are like little Tinder Boost fire kits. It comes with like a little thing. I don't even know if they're released yet. I just got it, so I wanted to share it with you because I don't want to look like I was the last on the boat, because if I do an adventure, it would still be a month before you saw this, and I wanted y'all to see this because this stuff's hot. So basically, it comes with 2 Tinder Boost pouches. In this little tin, you get a ranger band, then you get this little emergency whistle, fire starting ferro rod thingamajiggy. I own a bunch of these are really, really cool. And then you get a big, huge pinch of Fiberlite, which that could easily last you like four or five fires by itself. So they have these little adorable little tins already set up for you, which is pretty freaking cool. I mean, you can just buy these by yourselves, I'm sure, but they literally lasted like I'm not kidding. It was like 3 to 5 minutes before I even got to start trying to time it. And then I started timing it, and it was over 7 minutes, and the flames were still there, and I just put it out because, like, well, if it's over 7 minutes, I mean, even if the wood's completely soaked it with water, you're fine, you're good to go. Like, you're fine. So even the wettest wood will dry out if you got a substantial enough flame burning long enough. It'll just happen, especially if you build up your fire correctly. So like I said, and a lot of people go, Chris, why are you so addicted to fire? The reason why is everything in survival revolves around fire outside of pretty much your shelter. Outside of your shelter and fire, that's the quintessential building block for everything. That is safety, warmth, light, boiling water, cooked food. Everything revolves around the fire. It's something that should be very simple and very uncomplicated. But it's one of those situations where when it's raining outside, super high wind, super stormy. And that was the situation that Chris Deslow and I from Four Directions Bushcraft went into in the 3-day adventure. I'm giving you guys a sneak peek spoiler, as it were. The national forest that we were in was humongous. We were the little tiny itty bitty section that we were in was over 16,500 acres. It was humongous, like 18 miles across. We're just in a little section of the National Forest. Like, if you looked on the map, it's like this little tiny blip, and it's like the National Forest, like, right here. It was 18 miles in our section. So even if we left our section, we're still in the middle of a National Forest. Like, we're still, like, stuck. and the entire national forest had absolutely no signal because it's a national forest. There's nothing out there, so I had no signal. And we were having, there was intense flooding, there was thunderstorms and rain. It was crazy to experience that. The sense of, wow, like if something goes wrong, I'm actually in a survival situation. Like if my Celtic gets flooded out, it's going to be an 18-mile hike to get out of there. And there's no signal, so even if anyone's hurt, anything goes wrong, we can't call for help for like 30, 40 miles. Like, wow. And it really hit home, and I was like freaking out. So nothing obviously went wrong. I'm back. We are fine. We lived through it. We made it. You know, it was a super awesome, epic adventure. But it wasn't until we had some crazy stuff happen. I'm not going to give away everything because some intense, cool stuff happens during that 3 days. It was really, really awesome. Probably one of the most exciting short trips I've ever been on in my entire life. But, so, unofficially speaking, I have been working. I have been a super big fan of Cold Steel. Cold Steel knives. All their stuff. I got everything from them. Even my knife that was in my pocket that's over there on the counter. The Broken Skull. I own the Recon one. I own all that stuff. I love Cold Steel. And they don't really do a lot of sponsorships. They don't really like sponsor YouTube channels and like send them stuff. They don't do it a lot. Because they have a super big channel. So, I had another company called Redshift Gear. They sponsored me for this item right here that I'm a few items that I'm going to show you. But this is kind of my pride and joy right here. This is the Cold Steel Cheap Shot 130 crossbow. This thing is amazing. Don't let its compact lightweight size fool you. It has 130-pound draw weight on it, but it has this cocked lever right here that allows you to draw it. Well, there we go. Allows you to draw it and draw the string back and deploy it and keep repeating like a rapid fire really quickly. But running this through the crony, we're still pushing like 238 to 240 feet per second. That will take down an animal hardcore, like super hardcore. So if you want to hunt hog, but I think Lynn Thompson actually designed this based for Texas because of the fact that the limbs are so thin and so small and this is so lightweight. The brush in Texas is so thick, you wouldn't get through with anything bigger than this. That's why a lot of guys do blind and tree stand and all those kind of hunting in Texas, because you can't make it through the dense bush and still get a 40-yard shot. I mean, I felt like I was in heaven when I was up north, because there was no underbrush. There was just these big, huge trees, and you could see for like a half a mile off in the distance. I was going, this is amazing. The Eastern Woodlands are ferociously awesome. They're like the greatest thing. They're the great god. Like, people who can't hunt and take a shot there, I'm like, what are y'all doing? You can see for an hour. In Texas, I can't see more than 20 yards in front of me. Otherwise, I'm just going to... There's thorns and everything hateful in my face. So, the company... So, I told Cold Steel that I got that. And they're going to sponsor me. They're sending me some knives and some crossbow bolts and some cool little new broadheads that I get to test out. Super excited. But some more stuff from Cold Steel. That right there. This is the one first, yeah. So, in case I need to get up close and personal with a hog, like a boar, wild pig, obviously go after them with the crossbow, because we can. They're feral. I mean, the hogs are bad news here in Texas. They're also bad news in a lot of other states, too. But we got the Simbaru spear from Cold Steel. We got a couple of these from Redshift Gear. They sent us a few of these. And that's if, you know, we have to get up close and personal with it. Cold Steel is actually going to be sending us a really big, like, pig sticker knife. So if we have to, you know, do what we have to do, the thing that we don't like to talk about because YouTube will demonetize. But that, and then I have a guilty pleasure item right here that's coming up. This is, I've always wanted this, and I never pulled the trigger on it, and I don't know why. Because now that I have it, I'm like, why don't I have 8 of these? I got the Gunstock War Club. This is awesome! Oh my gosh, it's super great. So, it's basically got a 3-inch steel spike on it, and it's obviously solid polypropylene. It's a guilty pleasure thing. I just want to basically, for Halloween, just like, dress up as like Michael Myers and like smash bug pumpkins and scare little kids and stuff. I think it'd be fun. Obviously, do it from like a super safe distance of like, you know, 10 yards away. But yeah, that'd be awesome. Yes! Yes, John Rodriguez! Bacon! Bacon! So, like I said, I pretty much think that covers most of the stuff that I got over here that I brought over. Oh! That's the thing. Hey, Ryan, are you awake, bud? I'm not sure if my kids are awake. But for you guys who watched the live stream, because most of y'all who were watching last time, I got a new puppy. Her name is Freckles. She is... Yeah. Can you go get her? So, she, like I said, she's a pit bull, Walmarainer, and Rhodesian Ridgeback. When I got her, she was this adorable little puppy. I just hold her in my hand. She got big on me in 2 weeks. I left for 2 weeks, came back. She's like double the size. So I want to show you guys her real quick. And then I'll get into the giveaway winners. You guys have been super awesome. It's just... I wanted to catch up on everything, and I kind of used this clickbaitiness because I knew you guys would click on it. If I'm going to be honest with you, I mean, let's just be transparent. It's my channel. You guys decided to watch. I need y'all to watch. So, this is Freckles! Hey, baby.
Oh, look at this! Look how big she got! She got so big!
Hey, baby. I'm being all loud, and she's all being all nervous because... But she's only 11 weeks old, and she weighs over 15 pounds. She's a big puppy. There you go. I'm letting her have some training treats so she'll kind of be chill for a little bit. But yeah, she's a beautiful puppy. She's really, really, really cute. You can have it, baby. There you go. Yeah. There you go. But she's got big old paws. And what's funny, she's growing so fast is if you look at her teeth, she still has little bitty baby teeth. She has like her little 8-week-old baby teeth and she's growing like way faster than she can, so... I have to remember that because she's like 15 pounds and like she's going to be a big girl. I think she's going to be probably around 65 to 70 pounds because like I said, she's only 11 weeks old and she's like really big. She's huge. But here you go. You can go to mama, baby. There you go. Hi, baby. So, yes, she's going to be a big old dog. And I don't know if we're going to do in-home training or we're going to send her off to go to a trainer. Just because with all the adventures I'm going to be going on, I can't give her the time that I want to or she desperately needs. But because she's going to be so big, we can't afford her to be a untrained, rambunctious, crazy puppy. We need a well-behaved, beautiful, lovey puppy. So, like I said, we have all girls in the house. We have Margarita. She's my Chihuahua. We got Bella, who's my German Shepherd. And then we got Freckles. So... I got the giveaway winners right here. I have kept you guys on the hook for 28 minutes, and you guys have been absolutely awesome sticking with all my craziness because I feel I gave you legitimate updates, and I made sure I had some promo videos to go with it that I was filming while I was gone so you guys would have I'd have something to show you guys, and it wasn't just me talking about and showing stuff. I had promo footage so you guys could have something a little more tangible to see and check out. So, oh, and by the way, it's been on the bottom of the screen the whole time. For all premium members, the brand new members, every 60 days we're going to be holding private member-only giveaways to kind of say thank you and kind of just reinvest into the channel and reinvest back in everybody because I want to take the funds and most of, other than like me paying my bills month to month, we want to basically reinvest back into the channel, make really cool projects, have you guys involved in that process. But to say thank you for all the hard work that all of the premium members, our tribe members, are going to be giving, contributing to us by being moderators in live chat, throwing out ideas, giving us feedback privately beforehand. They're going to be kind of like our test panel, as it were. We want to do a giveaway because you guys are working really hard and you're also financially supporting the channel, if we're just going to be honest. So I want to let you guys know if you guys are in on that extra little perk, that's what's up. I think it's $4.99 a month. My moderator, so you guys signed off in the chat and confirmed that for me. I do believe it's $4.99 a month. Anyway, so the very first giveaway winner, and here's the promo footage for anybody coming in. Like, what was the giveaway? This is the giveaway B-roll. So I do believe you guys still hear me, but we had 5 total winners. Now, right there in that big, huge main section, right there at the center of the screen, that was our grand prize winner. So we have. Basically, 2 second place winners, 2 first place winners, and 1 grand prize winner. So we're going to start off showcasing the second place winners. So the first 2 people that I call off are going to be the second place winners. Then after that, we're going to have the first place winner. And then at the end of it all, we're going to have our grand prize winner. So make sure you guys understand kind of where that's coming from. But I want you guys to see the B-roll of all that. That right there, this prize pack... was that this is a first place prize pack right here, and the one you saw before that is a second place. So hopefully that gives you guys a better understanding of when I call out names, that's what you're getting. And if you're not sure what you're supposed to be getting, well, I'll tell you. So all right, so our first second place giveaway winner, which is still like a lot of loot, and we got to make sure we write all that stuff down in the boxes, cause I gotta make sure. So our first second place prize pack winner. Oh, and by the way, contact me either via email, which is on the back end of my channel, or preferably, so I'll actually get it, give me a PM on Facebook. It's Chris Thorne. I have my DFS symbol. Contact me there because I check that one more often. I kind of just like, I don't know why I ignore the Drop 4 Survival page. I think it's because Facebook has made it so hard mobily for me to get to. I have to have another app and it's so annoying. I end up posting to my my normal person friend one way more often. So contact me there. But the very first second prize winner, and her name is Samantha Well or Samantha Welly. I hope I didn't screw that up. But you are the first second place winner. And everybody who teamed up and subscribed to our channel and have been really supportive and got us basically 7,000 subscribers in 2 weeks. You guys have been amazing. That's so many people showing up to see all the crazy things that I have in store for the rest of the year. Because I'm like super amped of all the stuff we got going on. So with that said, after that, our second place winner is Derek Glantz. Woo! Derek Glantz, you are the second prize winner. So I got those taken care of. And if you weren't sure if I was ready to go, you want to hand me? Oh, yeah. Here, give me her. We're going to trade. Ugh. Come here, baby. Whoop. Sorry. I love you. Don't get mad at me. I love you. Mwah. We already have the stuff in boxes ready to go. I just got to put y'all's name on it and get a shipping label, and we're done. So it's already ready to go. You know, no bamboozling. It just took me a long time because I left. So ugh. Thank you, baby.
Yeah.
Okay, so now that we have both second place winners, we're going to start announcing first place. Woo. We're going to Patronus Charm that. Just another plug for my awesome fire steel. I'm being totally douchey about it because I'm super, like, I think it's the coolest thing ever. I'm a nerd. Leave me alone. So our first place winner is... Dun da da da. Get the Tinder app. Sorry, I'm just kidding. It's Tinder Boost. It is kind of funny, though. Kind of, a little funny. It's Thomas Ball. Woo! Thomas Ball, you are the first place winner for my 200,000 subscriber survival gear giveaway. Woo! Woo! First place. Then, our second and final first place winner. I smell joy about to enter in someone's life very quickly. It's going to consume you with joy and tears. You'll probably fart a little bit because you had probably some beans and some chips today if you're a fellow Texan. I have no idea if you are, but you should be. Because if you're not, you should. Texas is the greatest country in the world. Okay. I'm a dork. I need to calm down. Vanilla Gorilla! You are the first and final. Well, you're the second and final first place winner for my 2,000 giveaway. Blah, blah, blah. And I'm going to be nice. If you guys don't claim it on Facebook and send me messages and we don't get your addresses and everything set up, I'll give you guys like a week and a half or so to contact me. So hopefully by then you guys will have time to take some time off work, sit on the porcelain god and kind of just check your messages, get out of the shower, sit on, you know, do what I think. All that good stuff. So, our grand prize winner should be very, very excited. It's a lot of stuff. I don't even have a box big enough to put it in. Yet. I'm actually not looking forward to the shipping cost of this thing. Because it's going to be expensive. Like probably in the $60 to $70 range to ship all of it. Because I don't have a drum set and I'm too poor to get the sound effect for you guys. Our grand prize winner. After 35 minutes and 3 seconds of making you wait suspensefully on edge just to find out if you won. For all 373 people who decided to watch, and you'd be awesome and supportive of my thing. Ben and Jerry's! No, I'm kidding. That's an ice cream. That's not the person. You thought I was calling your name, didn't you? Freaked you out for a minute. Jerry Garcia! You were the winner. Grand prize winner. You were the grand prize winner. And there were the abilities to watch my 5-day series and comment and like and watch time and share. And another big reason is that this took us so long is because most people entered more than once. And so we had a cross-reference on the video. Make sure they're a subscriber. All that crazy junk. So that is all five winners blotted out right there. You guys saw it first. Like I said, we got some Coastal Crossbows. We have a dating app, Fire Boost. I'm kidding. We have 550 Blaze Cord. Like I said, guys, literally 10 bucks for 100 feet. It's freaking awesome. But love you guys to death. I'm hungry. I want to eat my salad because Chris Deslow and his folks at Afforded Extra Bushcraft fed me so good it got me fatter because their food was so delicious. They had so much food in their big, huge fridge. I didn't have to do with it all. So I'm going to go back to being a poor person and eat on my diet. So I love you guys. I'm out.